So when people are getting started with openEHR, I usually get this question. Like, I like the data models, I like what the CKM has to offer, and all of this looks amazing. But right now, we don't want to implement a whole openEHR system. Like, they don't want to do all the REST APIs and everything that openEHR comes with. Can I just adopt the data model from openEHR and just use them in my own application? And I just thought it's interesting to discuss a recent development from the Australian government. And this is actually the SPARKED AUCD profile. So this is the SPARKED AUCD core data set. Basically, it's the core data for interoperability release one. And if we actually take a look at how this fits in to all of what they're doing, so they are defining the data sets separately, and this committee is responsible for coming up with the AU core. That's what this document is. Then there will be a FHIR implementation guide on top of this, right? So they are defining the data models and the data structures, but they are not necessarily defining how the APIs will look like and how this will really work in the context of everything else. So that is for the technical implementers to like really do. And here I just want to show you a few examples of what they've really done with the clinical modeling here. And yeah, so they've started with things like adverse risk reaction procedures and vital signs like blood pressure. And this is like a list of all that's covered under the scope of the AUCDI R1. Now, this is just like a quick diagram, and I just want to show you, like, let's take, for example, and again, this is a quick document on the AUCDI. So it builds on the AU core, and then this feeds into this thing. So it's basically, there is going to be an implementation guide in FHIR that's completely separate from the data models that are going to be defined here, and somehow these two are going to work together. Now, if we take a look at one of the information models, right? Let's take a look at, for example, let's take adverse risk reaction, for example, right? So this, they define the context, like where it's to be used, consideration for use, misuse, where this is not supposed to be used, and so on. You can already see that, okay, this sounds a little like an openEHR archetype, right? And if you go into the data elements, and they have the description of each data element with examples. So for example, this is the substance name, it should be a codable concept, and here are some examples like amoxicillin, latex, and so on. And here they also include band-aid, so that's a text element, and it goes inside a coded text element. Again, like, this is very, very similar to the way openEHR does things. And to me, this makes a lot of sense, because sometimes you have the code for something, but sometimes you want to fall back on text to represent the particular concept. And all of this, if you come back, come down to the reference, they literally reference the openEHR CKM. And we'll just go and take a look at the openEHR CKM. I'm just going to open this to show how this looks like. So here is the adverse risk reaction archetype on openEHR CKM, and here is the adverse risk reaction summary roadmap for the Australian core data for interoperability. So now they have only picked and selected a few elements, right? Like, they have not selected everything that is available in openEHR. They have picked only certain elements, and I think that's a common pattern that we see even with the FHIR profiles. I think in one of the other videos last week, we discussed about the US core FHIR profile and how, because they didn't model all the required data elements, we see these other EHRs like Cerner and Epic just like trying to stuff in extra data as different resources, although this resource like could have had the data. Now it's interesting to see that, yeah, like, they're doing the modeling on top of openEHR, and they're like taking these archetypes as the main reference. And again, like, this is not just for adverse reaction. They've done this for almost all of the data points here. including like problem diagnosis, vital signs. Everything is based off of the work done on the CKM and based off of archetypes. But the implementation is yet to be released. So this is just the data. So when it comes to the implementation, it will be interesting to see how these archetypes and how these data models, which they have just represented here as just a generic, you know, chart and a table here, how this will really translate into something like FHIR, right? Because on one hand, yeah, FHIR kind of represents these things within the FHIR resource, but there will be certain elements that FHIR does not represent. And I'm just interested to see what they're going to do. Is that they're going to come up with extensions? Are they just going to, like, I don't know, invent their own resources? But I think that's like unlikely. I think they'll probably come up with extensions, or they'll just split this into multiple resources, right? Like what we saw with the pulse oximetry. So yeah, just thought this was like interesting because this is happening real time, and this was released very recently. And you know, the person behind this is also, like, if you go to the SPARKED data initiative, that is Heather Leslie, right? And she has been, I would say, a very important person in the openEHR community for coming up with almost most of the data models that we see on the CKM. So she is actively involved in the development of the Australian data set for interoperability. And yeah, Graham Greve, who's the inventor of FHIR, is also an Australian, and he is also probably involved with most of this. So it's interesting to see where this goes. And for a lot of people who ask, can I use openEHR and the openEHR data models? Like, can I use all of these data models in my application without actually using the openEHR APIs? I understand where you're coming from, right? Like, I definitely understand that there is a significant barrier of entry to getting started with openEHR and like getting the templates right and like starting to use the APIs. And all I have to say for you is that this is very much an evolving space, and we are seeing some people, for example, the AUCD profiles, like, they are pioneering this effort. They're trying to define the data models initially in openEHR, and then I want to see how the technical implementation goes. So I don't want to say that, you know, okay, this is a model that we can immediately follow. But it seems like there may be more upcoming ways of using the openEHR data models with other technologies, right? So there has also been a lot of discussion on discourse on, can we use openEHR data models with existing databases like MySQL or Postgres? And it's very similar to an ORM, right? Like, so you have an ORM in your program, and that takes care of modeling these things, and then that takes care of interacting with the database. Now, is it possible for these data models to then be coming from openEHR, and then for these tools to like work with existing databases? Now, there is a discussion on discourse. I'll you know, try to find that. And the answer to that was, well, yes, but it's a little bit more technical than that. So let's just search for ORM. So separating models from implementation. Yeah, I think this is the discussion. And this is a funny little thing, because this guy, Gary Wilson, I think he started off his username as like too stupid for openEHR, and then he just went on to say like, okay, this is just like too complex. What are you guys doing here? I understand the data models. Like, I see that, you know, there's a lot of work done on the data model side, and you know, you have all of these amazing data models that no one else in the world, like internationally, I think there has been no effort where this kind of mature data models exist anywhere else in health IT, right? So this is like one of a kind. Like openEHR, I think hands down, we could just say that this is the best source for clinical information on data models out there, right? Like nothing else comes even close. Like OMOP, FHIR, these are all like very rough. If you take any other open source projects as well, like not really, like they don't come close to the amount of rigor that has gone into openEHR data models. But then you see something like this where, okay, I see and understand the CKM and the openEHR models, but how can I use it across industries? The learning curve is just too steep, and I see a lot of companies and investors like walking away from openEHR because it's like really hard to just implement everything from scratch, right? Like, so the, again, the alternative that was suggested in this whole thread was that, okay, you could kind of take openEHR, you could use those models, and then you could use them with your own SQL databases, and you could have like a starting point there, and then you could develop on top of that. But I think, in my opinion, this needs to be explored a lot more, and using these openEHR data models outside of openEHR will enable other people who are like looking at adopting these systems to then go and try these data models out, right? Like, otherwise the alternative that you have right now is just look at the data models, look at your database, model them, right? Like, just look at them manually and start crafting these tables manually. And in my opinion, like, one of the reasons why FHIR is so popular today is because it lets people adopt parts of the FHIR standard with what they already have. So if somebody already has an application that's running on a MySQL database or that's running on a Postgres database, it does not ask them to completely reinvent the storage layer and all of their stuff, right? It tells them that, oh, okay, you just store it in however you want. We'll look at your implementation like a black box. And all you need to do is like make sure you, if somebody makes an API call to you with, like, let's say, give me all patience, you just do your transformation. You do all that internally. We don't care about how you do it. But when you return the data back, please make sure that these data elements are found. Whereas openEHR, what it does is like it takes a more rigorous approach to the whole data modeling in general. So they say that the system itself should be adaptable to innovation. So you can't really have this black box kind of a thinking. And like, it's not just about like moving data and exchanging data around. It's instead about, you have this engine which can be fueled by these different artifacts, which are like archetypes and templates and AQLs and so on. And that is a fundamental distinction, right? Like, so I see a lot of people trying to also use FHIR as their data repository. And it's, I get where they are coming from, right? Like, because, okay, FHIR already has a lot of these things in place. You have these data models in place, FHIR, although it's not even close to the maturity of openEHR International CKM, they still have more models and they have more health IT artifacts than a company or a developer starting from scratch, right? So they still look at FHIR and they're like, oh, okay, I can take these models, but then they can't extend them that easily and they'll just end up inventing their own models, right? Whereas in openEHR, it's like, okay, you start with this clinical data repository, you forget about your database, you forget about your own black box implementation, go with the openEHR implementation. Like, take a database like, not a database, take an implementation like EHR base, which is open source, or like go with a paid vendor. Like, you have many vendors these days, but go with one of these, and then you represent all of your data in this particular thing. And that to me is the main difference. And that I think makes a huge difference when it comes to implementation and how people adopt these standards. So final parting words, I would like to see openEHR data models be adopted outside of openEHR, right? Like, instead of just the openEHR data models being used within the openEHR engine and within the openEHR REST API, AUCD is trying to do something here. Right, like, I want to see what they do and what they come up with. But yeah, it's for us to see, and maybe you in the community have some thoughts about this. Maybe like let me know in the comments below. Yeah, maybe we can build an ORM based on openEHR archetypes and just use them in your application. Maybe possible. It just needs to be explored, and yeah, it's for us to build.